All right, what's up, guys? We are in the box truck this morning, and we are going to be making parting bead. And what is parting bead? It is a small strip of wood that goes in something called a dado in a historic window. And it's the dado is just a slot. I'll show it later. It is just about a half inch, but it's slightly under a half inch. So I'm going to show you how I do parting bead. So it doesn't need to be nailed in. We're actually going to be using a hand plane to put a small bevel so it will slide in and then wedge. So I'm going to start with sharpening my hand plane. And then I'm going to cut these pieces of stock to length. Then rip on the table saw 7/8 of an inch, so I'll get both parting bead sides for the window out of this piece of wood. So actually I'll flush cut this bottom piece. I really want to be wearing a mask right now, but I just can't and talk to you guys at the same time. So I have 59.5 with my measurement, so I'm going to go a 1/16 under that. Oh, that's right though. I'm at 1 degree. Some reason. All right, so I'm trimming out 5 windows. D9 and 7/16. We don't want the, and I'm actually probably going to run out of stock. No, I got some else up there. I'll make it work. I forgot what I was just going to say. 59. Cut all these. You know, these are at 1/2 inch. Dado slot is about 0.48 of an inch. Put that one a little too long. So trim it off just a tad. Get two out of this one, huh? Oh, come on. 9. It's a little short. Yeah, 5. Maybe it's time to use this. Yeah, let's use this guy. I don't like using this one. I kind of like to keep some wide stock. But, so I'm going to rip this one and then I'll cut them. do this audio. It's gonna be loud. We got all that cut up. Now it's time to actually sharpen my hand plane, which is actually called a low angle block plane. And I've got four Japanese water stones that we're going to use to sharpen. Keep that stuff right here. All right, this is my low angle block plane. Lee Nielsen makes it. It has an adjustable throat. Mine's a little sticky. I think it just has stuff in it, but this is to reduce tear out or to allow to take deeper cuts. So for the work I'm doing, we usually want it. You can see the light through it. Now somewhere just barely. Then that, because with I'm gonna be taking it out right now, but I'm just showing you. See, this pops, this twists here, and that comes out. This is the blade. This is how you move the blade forward and back. I believe this is called the frog. And then you've got your adjustments. This thing is fantastic. I love it. So now we're going to use the water stone. Four of them. 1,000, 3,000, 6,000, and 8,000 grits. And it goes pretty quick. This is for truing up the water stones as they get dished while you're sharpening. This is the and our truer. So we'll go with this, kind of get started. Get this out of here. Shaking the truck doing this. So you can, I don't know if you can see on the camera, but you can kind of see where I sharpened last. I think I sharpened a, oh, I don't know what the hell it's called. All right, I'm sharpening another hand plane, a rabbit plane. So you see right here, there's a color change. When you get a blade first, you need to lap the back, you know, like this, until it's consistent. And what we're going to do is drag, and that's going to create a burr as metal wraps around the edge. And then the very last thing we're going to do is lap that just a tiny bit to remove that burr, and that's how you get a super sharp blade. The problem with old hand planes, people think that the old hand planes are better, and they absolutely are not, especially if they've been not taken care of and you get rust pitting right along the blade edge. Then you don't get that burr created, so it never gets sharp. I already ran out of water. So I'm picking it up just a tiny bit as I go forward so it doesn't catch. I'm kind of bracing my arms against my body somewhat, See, now you can see it's turning darker. I can feel the burr building already. So now these are kind of polishing. And you can do it a little faster. This is a lot faster than now that, you know, the blade was already kind of sharp. So it doesn't take much to get it back to sharp. See, and you can see the metal in it. Now we're just gonna go get rid of our burr. And you can add a tiny bit of angle to it. That should be it. Oh, it feels nice. Let's see if we can shave with it. See the hair on it? It's hard to see in the light, but look at all the hair. Little bald spot. That's it. Really all there is to it. I've been sharpening now for, I don't know, 6 years? Religiously, so this is kind of how I like to start my day when I'm on site, is sharpen whatever hand planes I need to use. You know, I'm gonna sharpen my wife's hand plane right now too, just since I got this stuff out. I usually like to coat these in jojoba oil, and I don't think I have it with me. So just making sure it's really dry. Honestly, I'm surprised that more carpenters don't do this, because on this job site, I was watching a carpenter try to do something with the tool when this is the tool that he needed. I didn't say anything to him because it just wasn't my place. And he's actually a pretty amazing dude. I didn't want to maybe embarrass him, I don't know. But he just needed a hand plane. You'll hear this thing too when we start cutting. It just has this nice piercing, slicing sound. Actually, I don't know where her hand plane is, so it doesn't get sharpened. She doesn't need it today anyways. All right, well, I guess that's all there is to it right now. It goes back and away. And these need to stay submerged in water so they're ready to use. If you didn't do that, they're just going to keep absorbing all the water, and then the way that the water stones work is they wear out, and that's how they sharpen so quickly, and that's why you need to always keep flattening them. I really want to do some chisels right now, but I need to get these parting bead done so I can get some finish on them as soon as possible. All right. Oh, I didn't cut these two. Actually, 7/16. All right, so I'll make sure this guy's adjusted nicely. Not quite enough. Oh, my throat is not tightened down. Still loose. See, it literally looks like it's touching. That's how you really reduce tear out. So the low angle block plane with the adjustable throat is, it can be a tool for hogging, and it can be a tool for smoothing planing, which is a number four plane, is what you do smoothing. Okay, so the other thing we're gonna do and look at is we're gonna pay attention to grain direction, and that's kind of where this thing will help reduce tear out, but usually you need to be going with the grain, or else what's gonna happen is you're going to end up chipping and going straight in. You can see this tear out that's already happening. The grain is running this way. So see how it lifts up and drives under. So we're going to actually need to plane this way with the grain. So you can pull towards yourself or you can flip it around. And I'm actually going to make that the hidden part. Still not enough. So I'm just making micro adjustments. Here it kind of screams. That's the Alright, so I'm actually trying to bevel this, but I'm not doing a bevel really. I'm just gonna be actually the dado. The dado is 3/8 deep, and this is 7/8 across, so a half inch will be sticking out. So 3/8 is 3/8. You can see where I've already started planing. So we really want to end right here, and it's not the end of the world if you go over. And so we're going to reduce this. This thing's half an inch. The dado is probably about 0.48, so we don't have to take off much. And then it'll be press fit in. That might be all we need. Take a little off the other side to make sure we'll clear it. So the other thing I'll do is I'll leave it. I won't overdo it because you can't put it back. Then I'll go in and I'll do a test fit. And then if it's too tight, you'll see where the tight spots are, and you can just go with the handplane and true it up. That is. I'll do one more and I'm going to turn the camera off. Let's see if you can see this. You can see the burn marks from the blade, from the table saw blade. And I'm pretty sure grain's running this way. I am going against the grain a little bit, but that's where this thing is. Awesome. So, burn mark's gone now. So this is the equivalent to 2,000 grit sandpaper, if not more, all in one batch. So I just do the face. I don't worry about all the sides. So we're going to add that little relief. I'm going at an angle a little bit, kind of skewing it. That also can help cut. I've done about 500 windows in the 6 years, so I've done a lot of hand planing. I enjoy it too, it's kind of therapeutic. It's very satisfying too. Just the sound of it, the shavings, the dust, the look of it, how it feels in your hand. It's just fun. Finish. All right, I'm going to do the rest of these off camera, and we'll go inside and I'll show you how they fit and yeah, anything else. So I've finished the trimming in the truck and now I'm fine tuning them. They're not going in far enough and they're a little bit too tight, so we're gonna fine adjust them. So I got this plank to help pull them out. And now on here I can see where it's rubbing. So I'll go and just remove those parts. You can see it. Test fitting it. So I'll just keep test fitting it and hammering them in until they finally fit. At least where I want them. Put new marks on him again. You can see the rubbing. Now we'll remove it again. Doesn't take much. Just a pass. And we'll test it again. I prefer to have them where they're just tight enough. One more trim. should be perfect. Yeah. It's not the end of the world to need a tool to pull them out either. Perfect. All right, so this is flush now with the blind stop. See that? So now, you know, we'll put the head piece in, and these are done. So it's time to do some finish work on them because we got to do black shellac. And then start doing our weather stripping and then installation.